So let's look at our solution. When we have a problem like this, we first figure out the dependencies. There is one from here to here, and another one from here to here. And there is also a dependence here from R7 to R7. So now let's look at our ILP. So for ILP, we can do this and this in the first cycle. They don't depend on anything. This one needs to be done in the second cycle because it depends on the first two instructions. This one, however, can be done in the first cycle. This one cannot. It needs the R7 that is produced by this one. So this gets done in the second cycle. And then this one actually doesn't depend on anything, so it can also be done in the first cycle. So as far as ILP is concerned, we have a total of 6 instructions executed over 2 cycles, so the ILP is going to be 3. For the IPC, we have to worry not only about these dependencies, but also that this is a 3-issue processor and that it's in order. So this can still be done in the first cycle. This can be done in the first cycle. As far as 3-issue is concerned, this could be done in the first cycle, but because it has a dependence, we still have to delay it by 1 cycle. And now the problem is that in an in-order processor, once we don't execute an instruction, we cannot execute instructions past it because that would be out of order. So this is all that happens in the first cycle in this processor. In the second cycle, we are able to execute this instruction because now the first two are done. We can execute this one because now that this one is done, this is eligible for execution. And then we have to stop here because of this dependence. So this would have to be done in the third cycle. And again, we cannot do this. So in the last third cycle, we will be able to finally do this and then this because they don't depend on each other. So they can be done in the same cycle. So now we have 6 instructions over 3 cycles for an IPC of 2. It turns out that even if this was a 2-issue processor, the in-order property really would still limit us to an IPC of 2. So sometimes one of the things is going to be a limitation. Sometimes another limitation is going to play a dominant role. Sometimes all of the limitations are going to play a role in limiting our IPC.